Didn't you know? Super Mario World is a 1990 pet simulator released for the SNES and the spiritual successor to Super Mario Bros. 3. It is the first installment in the Super Mario World franchise, and the only one to ever be created outside of the accidental mislabeling of a Yoshi's Island game. Speaking of Yoshi, didn't you know that Yoshi wasn't originally going to be a dinosaur in Mario World? He was actually supposed to be a dog named Bear that the player would ride. However, the game designers thought this would negatively influence their younger players, and thus the design was changed to an animal that kids would never have the opportunity to climb on top of, and the name was changed to be more fitting for the new design. This didn't stop PETA from bombarding them with hate mail, however, which ultimately resulted in series creator Scott Cawthon closing his P.O. box once and for all. Mario World is famous for introducing the Cape power-up, which allows the player to fly across the air and glide across levels. What you might not know, however, is that this was actually a reference to the Marvel superhero Vision. This is most noticeable through the shared yellow color of their capes and the invulnerability that Mario receives when spinning the cape. One aspect of Super Mario World that surprised fans of Mario was the inclusion of the spin jump, a technique that allows the player to jump off of enemies and obstacles that would otherwise harm Mario. This attack was based off of the Street Fighter technique, Tatsumaki Senpukyak. This is seen through the similar motions as well as the similar functionality. They both not only allowed the player to continue staying airborne, but also damaged the opponent with their spinning attack. The references to Street Fighter continued later in other installments in the Mario series as well, most notably through the addition of the Shoryuken as one of Green Mario's special attacks in Super Smash Bros. Melee. Speaking of damaging attacks, didn't you know that the charging chucks introduced in Mario World were supposed to have another weapon that they would utilize in battle? They were originally going to complete the football-based appearance by having footballs that would be thrown at the player as they passed by. This was going to reference the Super Mario World TV show episode titled The Yoshi Shuffle. In the episode, Green Mario chisels a football out of stone, though it doesn't go quite as planned.
Hey, Mario! Look what I made!
It's a stone!
Green Mario.
You didn't make it!
It's a football! I chiseled it!
Well, what are you waiting for? Throw me a pass!
It's even official size!
While Cawthon was excited about adding in this reference, he was unable to get the rights to football, and thus it was unfortunately removed near the end of the development cycle. Super Mario World is famous for having one of the largest ROM hacking communities in all of video game history. The accessibility of ROM modification programs such as Lunar Magic has resulted in many popular ROM hacks being circulated across the internet, with one of the most infamous ROM hacks being known as Kaizo Mario, an intentionally difficult mod that is filled with pixel-perfect jumps and incredibly tight timings. The mod was created by an unknown Japanese man known as T. Takamoto, who sought to create the most difficult ROM hack of Mario World possible for his roommate. What may come as a surprise to fans, however, is that in a recent 2020 4chan post, the name T. Takamoto was revealed to be an alias. When written out phonetically as T. Takamoto and translated from Finnish to English, the alias is revealed to be a homophone for the Finnish phrase, make a forehead. This is a reference to the Twitch emote forehead, which is a 112 by 112 pixel image of famous League of Legends streamer Cadbury, known in real life as Josh Meyer. Josh was revealed to be the true creator of Mario Kaizo, and the supposed roommate the game was made for was actually all of his Twitch viewers themselves, a secret which he had kept under wraps by never playing any Mario-related games on stream so as to divert any suspicion from fans. This ultimately failed, however, resulting in Meyer's worst nightmare coming true, being invited to the next GDQ.
So, confirmed, Santa's number one helper is a squirrel.
I would really prefer if you would be quiet. But yes, you are correct.
$10 from Dracu. The Chompy 2 was my favorite childhood game, so I just had to count it for the first time.
Thank you so much for the run, and good luck.
Thank you.
Didn't you also know that prior to the release of The Legend of Zelda, there hadn't been a single video game ever released outside of Japan, barring a single copy of Teddy Dalglish Soccer Manager that had been leaked to Europe? If you want to know more trivia on Zelda and other obscure video game series, look out for the Didn't You Know Video Games episode on The Legend of Zelda. And don't forget to look out for new episodes of Didn't You Know Video Games. Hey guys, and welcome back to Endslate. So, question of the day. What do you guys think of Kaizo Mario and ROM hacks like that? I personally am a huge fan of Kaizo, and I actually played them all as a kid, so I've got a lot of fond memories of them. Reminder to check out my Shadow streams on Twitch. I've only got 6 runs done as of when I'm recording this, but I'm actually having a lot of fun, oddly enough. I'm sure that'll change by the 100th run, though. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.